Now show her this photo. See if it jogs her memory.
Neo Kobe Pharmaceutical Labs, can I help you? Huh? Oh, it's you, Gillian. What's going on?
Jamie, I can't see you very well from here. Well, I'm glad you called, but don't get carried away, alright? Jamie, we may not have any memories of our life together, but we can make them from here on out. Yes, but Gillian... I was really worried at first about becoming a junker. Of course, Gillian, people like us who have lost their memories never know at first what they're cut out for. What am I cut out for? You know, I don't think I made a mistake becoming a junker. I feel like I could really find myself through this job. I know what you mean. You get surprised by your own actions. You feel like you could see your inner self, right? But I wonder how long this can last. Chasing them down. Probably at least until our memories return. Queen's Hospital? Wait a minute. Let me check our records. Ah, here it is. They placed a large order for anti-cancer drugs from between October and December. Anti-cancer drugs, huh? I knew it. Well, that settles that. The director is Chinese, named Chin Shu Oh. Okay, okay, I need to look that up, actually. Chin. Just in case the name is reversed. I wrote the whole thing down. Our records aren't all that detailed, though. That's all I can tell you. I wonder who this Chin Shu Oh is. Never heard that name before. We have nothing on him here either. He might be one of those unlicensed underground doctors. Why don't you check your junker records? You might have something on him. I'll take a look at our data here, too. Thanks. That'll be a big help. Gillian, do you smoke? No, I need this for my investigation. I see. After all, hardly anybody smokes anymore. You know smoking is bad for your health. Don't even think about doing it, okay? Don't worry. I'm always chewing a piece of gum anyway. They give it to me at the agency. It's got adrenaline in it. Really? Not sure if that's so good for you either. Palace, huh? I wonder where it is. Moscow? It looks like a palace. I've never seen anything like that here. It must be far away. Oh, jeez, I figured it would jog her memory. We thought we recognized it. Jamie, I don't want to talk to you over the video phone like this. Let's meet and talk face to face. Gillian, I'm always thinking about you, but I don't know if you should see each other right now. We'll just run into the same old problems. If we don't get together now, we may have another... We may never have another chance. Please don't say things like that. This is hard on me, too. Well, it's true. I could get killed by a snatcher any moment. All right, Jamie. Let's call Napoleon. 395644. Oop. He's gonna be annoyed, but too bad. We can look up Chin Shu Oh in the database. What's this?
The number you have reached is not in service at this time.
Sure it isn't.
Please check the number and dial again.
Napoleon.
This is a recording. JT&T Neo Kobe.
Napoleon Telephone Service. That's funny. I'm sure I got the number, no, phone number right. No, you got it right. Perhaps the Snatchers have killed Napoleon, too. No. Huh? What's this symbol? Looks vaguely familiar. Yes. He's also the bouncer at Outer Heaven. He sneezes the exact same way. Where in the world has Napoleon gone? A wolfman. Aha! Now I understand. Gillian, I know where Napoleon is. Have you figured it out? Let's hurry up and head there. See if he knows anything about this Chin Shu. Oh, no, I don't have any option. Okay. Okay, I want to go to the computer room. Chin. Chin Sho-O. Director of Queens Hospital, age 41. Background, March 2043. Taken into custody and stripped of Class 1 medical license for involvement in eugenics scandal. Really? September 2045, arrested for operation of unregistered medical facility, stripped of Class 2 medical license. May 2046, arrested for violation of physical containment, handling of dangerous substances laws, permanently stripped of all medical licenses. Family, none. No data updates in 2047. Really? Yeah, you were of service. Let me just see if anyone has anything to say about this information. Probably not, but I'll see if we can ask anybody about Chin Sho-O. No. It seems I may have done something terrible in my past. Don't say things like that. Everybody makes mistakes, you know. So we need to head back to Alton Plaza then. Or we can just head straight for Outer Heaven. There's that. I wonder if I can talk to Katrina first. Make sure she's okay. And see if she knows anything about the stuff we found out. Probably not. But she might. I mean, after all, her father was a junker. I suppose Katrina's gone home by now. I'm sure she has, so nobody's in my apartment. I would be quite surprised if there was. You can be really cold-hearted, you know. Poor, lonesome Gillian. If only Jamie was here. Okay, I figured she'd hang out, but she's... Nobody home, eh? Figures. Please do not get too disappointed. Alright, never mind. I thought we'd find her here, but... the option to go back to Jean's house. Or it was now Katrina's house. What I'd like to do, well, I'd like to get out now that we're here. This is Outer Heaven. Is that Doorman with the wolf makeup again? It's the same makeup, but I cannot determine if it's the same person wearing it. Makeup that elaborate requires taking a cast of the face of the person who wear it. It's the same guy. I don't think it's a makeup, I think it's just a mask. Apparently it is not masquerade time right now. The neighborhood is quite festive, as usual. All the places around here are fully booked with Christmas and New Year's parties. A few drunks can be seen in the area just sitting by the road by the roadside. All the drinking and parties in the world won't get rid of them. They're for real. Gillian, humans are a rather weak species, aren't they? That's right, and it's just that weakness that those snatchers are trying to exploit. Hey! Are you who I think you are? Hey! What are you doing? Lay off! If you don't lay off, I'll have to call someone out here. Yeah. I'll see if he will. Are you crazy or something, mister? You really remind me of someone I know. I bet that's you, right, Napoleon? I don't know what you're talking about. I don't know anybody named Napoleon. Let's trick him. I know it's you, Napoleon. Now cut this stupid act. I'm afraid you've got the wrong man, sir. Hey, I'm just a doorman. What a bother. Do you have any proof that this Napoleon and I are the same person? We're interrogating. You're going to have to show me some proof, sir. Proof? You want proof? What proof will we give him? What? You've been going on like this and you don't even have any proof? You still don't know how to use your head, do you? Everything will be fine. I guarantee your safety. Don't worry. Now take that mask off. Okay. I don't know what kind of proof we're gonna give him, but... let's give it to him. Oh, really? You have all this time? Body type, vocal pattern, accent, personality, and smell. That's it. You and he are the same height. If that's proof, then I'm a policeman. Your height is the same. Almost nobody is as short as you are. That's no proof. Yeah, you have the same voice. That's it. Not the best reason you've got. That's it, Metal. Analyze his voice print against that of Napoleon. I'm sorry, Gillian. I haven't stored any of Napoleon's voice data. I won't let it happen again. Well, it's really too bad. Your voice sounds just like his. I know. The two of you talk the same way. That's no proof. Your accent and word choice is just like his. Not the best reason you've got? Yeah, that wormy, untrustworthy attitude of yours is just like him. No two people could have that same personality. So what? What's that supposed to mean? I've got it. You smell just like him. Huh? Gillian, what did Napoleon smell like? You shut up. It's no proof. Achoo! Excuse me. I just want to try this one more time, though. I'd know that B.O. anywhere. You're Napoleon. B.O. Bless you. Now I've got it. It's that sneeze. I remember. You sneeze just like him. He has hay fever. Achoo! Alright, you win. I've had enough fun for now. I just wanted to play with you for a bit. Nice work, Gillian. You're a first-rate chunker. Go on in.
Have a seat, Gillian. We're safer in a crowded place like this.
Jeez, you really had me fooled. Two rolls in one.
This isn't tight.
Well, you know, you gotta understand. Being an informer isn't exactly the safest job on the planet, you know. That's why it's important to be a master of disguise, like me.
Yeah, but I feel pretty stupid. I mean, all that time I was asking you about where Jean went, I didn't realize I was asking someone who actually worked there.
Hey, I was just as surprised as you were. But I didn't know that Gibson had been here. You see, I wasn't working that day.
Anyhow, it's not masquerade night today. Why don't you take that mask off, Napoleon? It's a little unnerving sitting here talking to a wolf.
Alright. I suppose there's no harm there. Boy, you really work up a sweat in these full-face masks.
Oh, boy. Maybe you should have left that on.
What?
Regretting it already. Bless you.
Still, you did a nice job of figuring out who I was.
Come on, Napoleon. That stupid phone recording with the Wolfman? JT&T would never do anything that tasteless. Besides, what really tipped me off was that constant sneezing of yours.
Yep.
Sneezes, eh? Well, listen, you want me to tell you why I'm called Napoleon?
Yeah.
Because winter gets the best of you.
Because he's
Napoleon
short.
Napoleon Bonaparte sent his enormous army into Russia in 1812, but suffered a major defeat because of the snow.
Oh, I get it.
Yeah. Mm. The sneezing isn't a cold. It's my allergy to snow 9 pollen. So, anyhow, what did you want to know?
You gotta come along with us.
I've got a couple of questions to ask you.
Fire away.
Now, what's interesting is that his head with the wolf mask on is a lot narrower than his actual head. looking at you like this, you look pretty normal, don't you? Normal? Just what's that supposed to mean, huh? Mind your own business. That doorman look suits you, Napoleon. Heck of a lot better than that Santa getup, anyway. It's not masquerade time at the moment, but don't be staring at the customers, okay? Makes them nervous, you know? What do you think? We do pretty good even when it's not masquerade time, don't we? Too bad Isabella's not here. Don't worry, there are no suspicious looking types at the moment. I thought it was still on look. This is not plywood. In fact, it appears to be a very high quality stock. I've scanned for listening devices and there are none. Feel free to discuss anything you like. Come on, Napoleon says, you gotta learn to trust people. Mm-hmm. There are no security cameras here. Hey, aren't you gonna go trust me? I'm the real thing, alright? Unless you start trusting people, you're gonna lose all your friends. Are we friends? Show him some stuff. This is part of a patient's file that we found. Would you take a look at it? What are you showing this to me for? I don't know the first thing about medicine. Yeah, these are our matches. How's that for the nostalgic approach, eh? We only give them out to our regulars. So that means that somebody from Queen's Hospital comes here. Those are definitely our matches. Maybe Lucasland? I heard that they closed down about 3 years ago, but I guess that wasn't the case. No, that's not it. Never seen that building before. What's with the patient's record? I don't get what you mean. I have to actually ask him. You can only ask him about his background right now. You're Chinese, right? That's right. Purebred. Purebred, I might add. I came to Neo Kobe just after I turned 20. My only memories of the place are from after they lost the war. It wasn't a pretty picture. I'll tell you, the catastrophe really changed my life. Everything about it. That was a crazy time. Would you take a good look at this for me? What's it mean? You're Chinese, right? Well, well, I'm not surprised that you had trouble with this. What's that mean? These are Chinese characters for chemical elements, hardly in standard use. If I wasn't a science major, I probably wouldn't know them myself. It's a simple code using the characters. Meaning of code. What's this about Chinese chemical element characters? What do you mean? The character on the far left is beryllium. The next one and the very last one are nitrogen. The third one stands for sulfur. The fourth one is oxygen. I'm writing this all down. Okay, so from left to right, which I know isn't the way we actually read it, but beryllium, and then nitrogen, as well as the last one. Sulfur. Okay, so I wonder what this makes. Something to fight. Snatcher cancer, or to make the skin? Okay, so we've got beryllium, nitrogen, sulfur, oxygen, nitrogen. It almost spells out the word Benson. Missing an E. Beryllium, nitrogen, sulfur, oxygen. I've got it. Gillian, let's go over the names of these elements, shall we? Infer? Well, let me just... Chinese characters for elements. In the order they're written, beryllium, nitrogen, sulfur, oxygen, nitrogen. Right. Before I infer, I just want to look at this again. I didn't mean to hit that. Well, at least we figured out that the characters stand for chemical symbols. Whose name is on this file? Please input your guess. I figured it wasn't supposed to be somebody's name. Just, some kind of substance they use when making those chemicals for use in the hospital environment. I'm not sure. Benson sounds vaguely familiar.
So that's it. Benson. Beryllium is BE, nitrogen is N, sulfur is S, and oxygen is O.
Oh, BE for beryllium.
And N makes Benson. The name Benson was encoded on this file.
Benson. I sure hope it is not referring to the chief, Benson Cunningham.
Oh.
Or to our friendly engineer, Mr. Harry Benson.
Oh, really? They pulled up Benson?
No, that couldn't be. No way.
But the possibility, though remote, does exist.
Metal, I want you to cut off all your data transmissions to headquarters now.
Understood. Now disabling automatic transmission routines. Done. No further data transmissions to headquarters will be executed.
My God. A snatcher in Junker headquarters?
Good God.
We gotta get there quick. Let's go, Metal.
See you later, Junker. Today's little information tidbit is on me. Now take care, Gillian. Don't get yourself taken out by some snatcher. I think I'll lay low for a while.
Thanks.
Now, after all, you are my main source of income.
You be careful too, Napoleon. You get killed and you won't be able to sneeze anymore.
What's that supposed to mean?
See you, Napoleon. Metal, let's go.
Okay, wow. No wonder Benson sounded familiar. It's the first or last name of, I think it's the first name of the chief and the last name of Harry. Yeah, Harry Benson. And then Benson whatever for the chief. Wow. So it's one of them, as before. We have two suspects. One of them's a snatcher. One maybe not. But we're going to check that out next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next one. Really enjoying this. Freaking awesome. Always seek adventure.